Hello, welcome back to our chemistry class. We are learning the last lesson, world of carbon. In the previous day, we studied about global warming, its consequences and solutions. Hope you all understood the concept well. So, dear children, we saw what are the consequences happens on Earth as a result of the increased concentration of carbon dioxide. Today we are going to continue the compounds of carbon. So we discussed about carbon dioxide and we learned carbon dioxide formed as a result of combustion of carbon or carbon compounds. Now let's analyze the uses of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is used in fire extinguishers. We learned that carbon dioxide doesn't support combustion, because carbon dioxide is heavier than air and it makes it easier in extinguishing fire. Next, carbon dioxide is used to produce carbonated soft drinks and soda water. Dry ice. Have you heard of dry ice? When carbon dioxide gas is compressed at a room temperature and pressure is suddenly released, it solidifies to form dry ice, which is also known as solid carbon dioxide. This dry ice is used as a refrigerant and also to create foggy effects in stage shows. The next use of carbon dioxide is used in the manufacture of washing soda and baking soda, and also used for the manufacture of chemical fertilizers like urea. The another important use of carbon dioxide is used to stimulate breathing in the treatment of respiratory diseases in the form of carbogen. Carbogen is a mixture of 95% of oxygen and 5% of carbon dioxide. And this carbogen is used for artificial respiration. So these are some of the uses of carbon dioxide. Now shall we learn about the compound carbon monoxide? Well, carbon monoxide is a colorless, odorless gas having density less than air. Its formula is CO. Carbon monoxide is formed by the incomplete combustion of carbon. Don't you remember how carbon dioxide is formed? Yes, carbon dioxide is formed by the combustion of carbon and carbon compounds. But carbon monoxide is formed by the incomplete combustion of carbon or carbon compounds. If the relative amount of carbon increases or that of oxygen decreases, the reaction takes place as given below. 2C plus O2 gives 2CO. The gas formed is called carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a poisonous gas. Do you know what carbon monoxide does to our body? Let me tell you, when carbon monoxide is inhaled, it reacts with the hemoglobin in the blood and forms carboxyhemoglobin. As a result, the oxygen capacity of the blood decreases, leading even to death. That is, the affinity towards the hemoglobin increases and forms carboxyhemoglobin. As a result, what happened? The oxygen capacity of the blood decreases and leads to death. All right. Now, let's discuss the measures that can be taken to avoid the situations that produce carbon monoxide. Dear children, carbon monoxide is formed by the incomplete combustion of carbon. Therefore, we have to control such situations that produce carbon monoxide. Following are some of the situations. Never burn charcoal inside a house. Reduce the use of gas stove that emits carbon monoxide. Service fuel burning appliances annually. Place portable generators outdoors on a dry surface far away from home. So these are the certain measures that can be taken to avoid the situations producing carbon monoxide. Though carbon monoxide is said to be a poisonous gas, it has several uses. Shall we see? Carbon monoxide is used as a gaseous fuel, and it is used to produce industrial gases like water gas, a compound formed by the combination of carbon monoxide and hydrogen, and to produce producer gas formed by the combination of carbon monoxide with the nitrogen. This carbon monoxide is also used as a reducing agent in metallurgy. So these are some of the uses of carbon monoxide. So children, we discussed about carbon monoxide, how it is produced, why it is said to be a poisonous gas, and its uses. Let's move on to the next compound, carbonates and bicarbonates. Already we learned about carbonates and bicarbonates in the lesson 5, acid, bases and salt. So let's recall once again the important carbonates and bicarbonates in this lesson. Washing soda, known as sodium carbonate. Chemical formula Na2CO3.10H2O. Baking soda, known as sodium bicarbonate. Chemical formula NaHCO3. And limestone, commonly known as marble, chemical formula CaCO3. Dear children, till now we discussed about the inorganic compounds of carbon like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, carbonates, bicarbonates, etc. In the next video, we will see the organic compounds of carbon. So please watch the next video.